Hi Scorpio, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and let's do your weekend love bite. Scorpio, this is a general collective read, will not resonate with each and every one of you. So take what works for you, leave the rest. So Scorpio, let's begin. This is a small little mini read to just to check on your energies for the weekend of the 6th of November, 6th, 7th, 8th. Okay? Dear God, goddesses, angels, spirit guides, please bless this reading for Scorpio and send them the messages they need to hear the most at this time. Thank you. So Scorpio, as always, we're going to take a blessing first and then get on with your reading. Let's see what my angels have for my Scorpio gang for the weekend. My angels, a blessing or an advice card for Scorpio, please. Blessing or an advice card for my Scorpio, please. This one, okay. Let's put this here. So the card the angels give you, Scorpio, is signs from above. This is one of my favorite cards. I always love this card and I get very excited because I feel I start looking out for these signs. So these signs can appear as repeating numbers, or maybe you suddenly see a book that you read, or a billboard, or a white feather comes your way, or you hear a repeating song, when you're listening to music and the lyrics talk to you, or maybe you meet somebody who says something to you which really strikes you. It could be the tarot reading, Scorpio, you never know. So these are all nudges from the universe directing you to the right direction. If you have been struggling with something, look out for the angels there around you and they are guiding you towards a solution or towards, your correct path. Okay, so let's begin your reading and see why this card is here for my Scorpio gang. Welcome back my subscribers. Thank you for showing up. I'm very blessed to have all of you here with me. Thank you so much. And if you're new here, we welcome you to our Omkara family. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, and yes, we welcome you. Just a small little 9-card spread to check your energies right now. Scorpio, your longer readings are coming, don't worry. And if any of you need a private reading, my schedule is open. You can reach me at my email in the description box below. Dealing with a King of Swords, no wonder. Oof, Scorpio. I hope this is not you. Let's see. Page of Swords in reverse, Two of Pentacles in reverse, and the World in reverse. Empress in reverse, Five of Pentacles upright, and the Two of Wands. Were you dealing with somebody in your life, Scorpio, who... King of Swords in reverse is a character who is not the best communicator. They can sometimes be very rude. They can be harsh. They can say things or do things which can hurt you beyond measure. This is can be a grown person, but immature as in, in their behavior. So the person is coming across as the Page of Swords, always, kind of checking up on you, immature behavior, gossiping, just doing everything what a mature person shouldn't, I guess. And I think you made a choice maybe in the past to drop this person. Yeah, you became clear, you wanted to cut this person off, right? Or you have cut this person off and you're kind of dropping the ball on them. I don't see this chapter totally closed yet right now, Scorpio. You may not be with this person, but that doesn't mean the chapter has to close. Maybe there's unfinished business between the two of you. But I do see you, Scorpio, taking a fresh leap of faith and moving ahead. And making your own choice and your own path ahead. Now, this could be you, Scorpio. This could be your cross-watcher, okay? So just be aware, energies can be flipped. So what's this Two of Pentacles in reverse spirit for my Scorpio? Yeah, you want to heal from all that, this person has put you through, I think you wanted to heal, and you have decided to make a decision that I'm going to, you know, never find balance in this relationship, so I might as well find balance in my own, right? You want to make a decision that, hey, listen, I want a fresh leap of faith. I am cutting you out now, and I'm not interested, I guess, in you. And yes, there you are, the Empress in reverse. Now, the Empress upright is a very nurturing and abundant and fertile energy and bringing warmth and love. But in reverse, this is not somebody who wants to invest in a person, right? Maybe there was a decision that this Empress made this decision about this very happy home or a long-term relationship, and kind of put a spoke in the wheel here and stopped working on this relationship, stopped giving this energy of the Empress, the nurturing, or, you know, Empress is like perfection. So when the Empress is in your life, then you know your life is good, right? So the Empress being in reverse means that this Empress has now turned the Queen of Swords and is now no longer giving attention to this, maybe at one time a stable energy, because they always felt left out in the cold by this King of Swords. Look at these two energies. I mean, they're equal match, maybe. Could be a married couple or whatever, I don't know. But there's a King of Swords and a Queen of Swords, but the King of Swords is in reverse, right? So if this person was upright, that they could have had a conversation, clear communication, and solved an issue. But how can a Queen of Swords have any kind of communication with a King of Swords who is not ready to listen, who's ready to cut you with his words, right? So this Queen has now turned away from this King of Swords now, because they always felt left out and abandoned in the cold, neglected by this King of Pentacles. So no longer now deciding to give energy to this relationship anymore, and kind of dropping the ball here, dropping the fight and saying, hey, listen, I'm going to start planning my own future now. I have the world open in front of me. Why am I staying in a place which is giving me so much unhappiness? Yes, this Empress has a lot of love to give. The Empress has a lot of love to give and is now realizing that, hey, you know, I don't have to stay in this place forever. I look at this world, it's so big and beautiful, and I have so many options in front of me. I can choose to go anywhere or be with somebody new if I want, because I have a lot of love to give. And all this love, that first I'm going to direct it towards myself, find self-respect, find self-love by not giving attention to somebody who disrespects me, and maybe go and find another option who can be worthy of my love. So that's where you're at, Scorpio. Let's see. The High Priestess, the Star, and the Hangman in reverse. Good, good. So I think you're not really talking to anyone about this, Cancer. Scorpio. You are keeping things to yourself. You are wanting to find victory for yourself, and you're still in that place where you're going back and forth in your mind, and you are wondering which direction is going to give you your happiest time, right? You're trying to use your intuition to find victory for yourself. Why is the Star in reverse then, Spirit? Why is the Star in reverse this weekend for Scorpio? Because I think there is still a lot of love here. And this, you know, you feel your wishes have not come true of putting a halt to this relationship, because this King of Cups, even though it was manipulative, did not give you what you wanted. You did have a lot of love for this person. This is again an equal match. I'm seeing Queen of Cups to the King of Cups. And at one point you may have thought that this is, you know, my soulmate is going to be forever and ever in my life. But as I always say, Scorpio, soulmates come into your life for a reason, season, or a lifetime. Sometimes they come to teach you a lesson. And when the lesson is over, then the chapter is also over, right? So right now, you're still not feeling happy. You still feel your wishes didn't come true, because this you felt was a special connection to you, and it could have been beautiful, but you are still kind of in your head to knowing that your wishes did not come true now, and you're wondering what is the best path forward now. Should I move forward for my own victory, or should I go towards this King of Cups? You are in contemplation, but I think this weekend you're going to make up your mind and come out of this hermit mode that you've been in. Yeah, I think here you are at crossroads still kind of deciding what to do. I have the world in my hands now. What is the decision which is going to be the best for me? You don't feel stable where you are, that's for sure. Yes, I have a feeling, Scorpio, you are going to be manifesting a brand new life for yourself. You are planning to shut this chapter off completely. This chapter which has been open for so long, I think this weekend you are manifesting the shutting down of this chapter and manifesting a brand new one. So what can we expect, Spirit? What can we expect for Scorpio this weekend? What can we expect now? You're moving towards new love, Scorpio. Here you are manifesting a brand new love for yourself, a new life for yourself, and closing out any chapter in your life which is still open. You're getting the signs from above that it's time, Scorpio, it's time. This connection has maybe now come to an end, but we are sending you, universe is sending you love, your life. You've been hoping, praying, manifesting it. So look out for the signs. It's time maybe to shut this chapter and start a brand new one. This could be with the same person if this person is your soulmate and wants to come back in your life, but they have a lot of work to do yet. It's from what I see. If there is true love there, maybe they will end their old ways of dealing with you and start a brand new chapter with you. Or this very well could be a new love coming your way, Scorpio, which is going to be pure, new, fresh. And I think you have been praying for it. You have been manifesting it. Right? So let's see now what your next reading is going to bring for you. Till then, love and light. Take care. Namaste, Scorpio.